The dot product, level 5. In this video, we will go over how to find the angle between two vectors. We will also go over a couple examples. Recall from the previous videos that we developed an expression for the geometric definition of the dot product. Let's go ahead and formally prove the geometric definition. Let's start by drawing vector A and vector B aligned tail to tail at the origin of a three-dimensional coordinate system. Let's call the angle between the vectors theta. Next, let's draw a vector that starts from the head of vector B and ends at the head of vector A. Let's call this vector vector C. Now we have a triangle with vectors as sides. Let's label the vertices of this triangle as point O, point A, and point B. Notice that this setup has all the characteristics of a classical trigonometry problem. We can easily find theta if we knew the lengths of all three sides. All we would need to do is to use the law of cosines to figure out the angle. Recall that if you had a scalene triangle with lengths A, B, and C, and theta, the expression for the law of cosines would be C squared equals A squared plus B squared minus 2 times the product of A and B times cosine of theta. Unfortunately, our triangle is formed by vectors, but we can use the law of cosines to start our proof. We would first need to make a couple of adjustments. First of all, let's use the vertices of the triangle to denote each of the line segments. By making this substitution, our expression now becomes line segment AB squared is equal to line segment OA squared plus line segment OB squared minus 2 times the product of line segment OA and OB times cosine of theta. Next, observe that the length of each line segment is nothing more than the magnitude of vector A, B, and C. So we go ahead and replace line segment AB with the magnitude of vector C, and replace line segment OA and OB with the magnitude of vector A and B, respectively. Doing that, we obtain the following. Then, we need to rewrite vector C into an expression that contains both vector A and vector B. Taking a look at the diagram, we see that vector C is nothing more than vector A minus vector B. So we go ahead and replace vector C with this expression. Now the law of cosines looks like this. At this point, we are done using geometric properties. Now we will finish the proof by applying a couple of algebraic properties of vectors. Let's start with the left side of the expression. Using the dot product properties, we can rewrite the magnitude of vector A minus vector B squared into the quantity of vector A minus vector B dotted with itself. Then, we go ahead and multiply the vectors just the way you multiply polynomials. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Now we go ahead and rewrite the first dot product as the magnitude of vector A squared. The second and third term add to 2 times A dot B, and the fourth term becomes the magnitude of vector B squared. Alright, now we can replace the left-hand side of our original law of cosines expression with this new expression. At this point, it is just a matter of simplifying the expression. Notice that the magnitude of vector A squared and the magnitude of vector B squared both cancel out. The constant negative 2 also disappears, and we are now left with a geometric definition of the dot product. And this ends the proof. This expression is very useful in finding the dot product, but it can also be used to find the angle between two vectors. Notice that the magnitude of vector A times the magnitude of vector B simplifies to a real number, so we can actually divide this expression out, obtaining a rearranged form of the dot product. In this case, cosine of theta equals the dot product of vector A and vector B divided by the product of the magnitude of vector A and the magnitude of vector B. Note that the angle between the zero vector and another vector is not defined here. Alright, Let's go ahead and go over a couple of examples that makes use of this rearranged form of the dot product. Find the angle between the vectors, approximate to the nearest degree. Here we have two planar vectors, and we are asked to find the angle between these two vectors. Keep in mind that the angle between the vectors will always be an angle between 0 degrees and 90 degrees, an acute angle. We usually do not bother finding an obtuse angle, so keep this in mind when you're finding the angle between vectors. Alright, let's start by finding the magnitudes of each planar vector. So we go ahead and use each vector's components and substitute them into the magnitude formula. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the following for the magnitudes of vector A and vector B. Next, let's use the rearranged geometric definition of the dot product and substitute the various values on the right side of the expression. Computing the dot product between vector A and vector B, we obtain the following. Simplifying the numerator and denominator, we obtain the following value for cosine of theta. Finally, it is just a matter of solving for the angle. So we take inverse cosine of both sides. Simplifying the expression and rounding to the nearest degree, we obtain 14 degrees. So this is the measure of the angle between vector A and vector B. Let's try another example. Here we are given two vectors in space, and we are asked to once again find the angle between vector A and vector B. Similar to the previous example, let's go ahead and first find the magnitudes of each vector. For vector A, we go ahead and use the formula for the magnitude of a vector. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the following. Then, we do the same for vector B, which yields the following value for the magnitude. Next, let's go ahead and use the rearranged geometric definition of the dot product and substitute the various values on the right side of the expression. The dot product between vector A and vector B simplifies to 5, and the product of the vector's magnitudes simplifies to 21. Finally, it is just a matter of taking inverse cosine of both sides. Rounding to the nearest degree, we obtain 76 degrees as the final answer. Alright, let's try the next example. Here we have two vectors in space, written in standard unit vector form. Recall that each unit vector is associated with a particular component, so we can rewrite vector A in component form as follows. We can also do the same for vector B. Next, let's go ahead and compute the magnitude of both vectors. Doing that, we obtain the following. Then, we make use of the rearranged geometric definition of the dot product and substitute the various values on the right side of the expression. Evaluating the dot product and multiplying the magnitudes of each vector, we obtain the following value for cosine of theta. Finally, we take inverse cosine of both sides and approximate the value to the nearest degree, obtaining 101 degrees as the final answer. Okay, let's go over the final example. Here we have two planar vectors, written in standard unit vector form, and using the direction of the vector. Like in the previous examples, let's first rewrite each vector in component form. We will start by evaluating each of the trigonometric expressions. For vector A, cosine of 3 pi over 4 and sine of 3 pi over 4 reduce to the following values. And for vector B, cosine of 2 pi over 3 and sine of 2 pi over 3 reduce to the following values. Next, let's go ahead and distribute the scalar on each vector. Now that we have our vectors in component form, let's go ahead and find the magnitudes of each vector. For vector A, we obtain 5, and for vector B, we obtain 2 for the magnitude. Next, we use the rearranged geometric definition of the dot product and substitute values for the right side of the expression. The dot product between vector A and vector B simplifies to the following value, and the product of the magnitudes of vector A and vector B reduces to 10. Manipulating the expression and simplifying, we obtain the following. Finally, we solve for theta by taking inverse cosine of this expression, giving us exactly 15 degrees for the final answer. Alright, in our next video, we will go over slightly more challenging examples.